behind the bar, next to the bathrooms. Speaking of bar, it is open. Please go visit Leanne. And we're streaming tonight, so I want to say hi to everyone watching at home. And a thank you to DPM Events for your support in streaming this evening. So, tonight is very special. Can I have Sandra Thompson and Tom Abrahamson come up with me? So, as many of you know, tonight is Sandra's last open mic as a staff member here at the Acorn. It will not be her last open mic either as a patron or as a performer, I am sure. So you all will have the privilege and pleasure of seeing her again, and she is performing for y'all tonight. But we... In honor and acknowledgement of your 9 years of service to this fantastic organization, we have a little something for you, and Tom wanted to say a few words, but I wanted to say we're really grateful and you will be missed, and I'm gonna turn it over.
All right, thank you. Hey, Sandra. So I hope you don't mind if I spend a little bit of time talking about this amazing woman right here. My name is Tom Abrahamson. I have the great honor of serving as the chair of the board of directors of the Acorn. I've worked with Sandra very closely for about 4 years. And on behalf of our board, and there are a number of boards. I see some people waving, thank you. I want to share some thanks and some praise about Sandra. Well, Sandra began her work here in 2013 as the theater's general manager when the Acorn was a for-profit business, the vision of founders David Fink and Kim Clark. Then, in 2016, in a bold move to expand the Acorn's reach and impact and to put the Acorn on a path to live on for what we hope is forever, Sandra led a complex effort to convert this for-profit business to a nonprofit organization. This is no easy undertaking. Yet, in just 5 years under Sandra's leadership and relentless devotion, the Acorn has accomplished what typically takes decades and often never even happens at most other nonprofits. So today, the Acorn is a thriving, growing organization with limitless opportunity ahead of us. And I credit this success to Sandra's skills and experience in the performing arts business, her unstoppable energy and her contagious enthusiasm that has resulted in a loyal and devoted patron base, our artists, and an army of volunteers and donors. I would be remiss if I did not also recognize the role Sandra played in recruiting many former and current board members and the board's tireless efforts working alongside Sandra in driving strategy, business planning, and fundraising efforts. Simply put, there would be no Acorn as we know it today without Sandra Thompson. Right? That's right. All right, there's more. One quick standing ovation. We got more. Okay. So, I have a little bit more to say. You know, Sandra worked pretty much 24/7. She was the Acorn's only full-time employee, managing the theater's business and conducting hundreds of events over the years. She innovated so many programs, such as our open mics, Acorn Homegrown, the singer-songwriter and 10-minute playwriting competitions, and radio plays. About a year ago, after Sandra decided to shift her role from executive director to artistic consultant, among other things, she orchestrated a stunning pivot during the pandemic and created dozens of Acorn Anywhere outdoor concerts, which enabled the Acorn to survive 18 months when this theater was dark. I know there's more, but this is the short version of Sandra's accomplishment. Finally, as a testament to Sandra's pure devotion to the Acorn, after we conducted a national search and hired Sandra's successor, Beth Caskell, as executive director, Sandra could not have been more generous and more caring in helping her make a successful transition to the role. Fellow board member Bob Beamer, where are you, Bob? Raise a hand, there you go. He summed up what is perhaps Sandra's most admirable accomplishment. And he says, the sense of community that Sandra envisioned and orchestrated. She created a theater with a warm, inviting feel, a place you have to bring your friends, a place where magic happens. So on behalf of the Acorn Board, we have a little token of our appreciation for you, Sandra. This print, which I think you should all take a look at, is appropriately titled Open Mic by local fine artist Joe Hindley. It depicts the energy and excitement every time we host an open mic night here at the Acorn. We hope you enjoy it. Wish you all the best in your next adventures. Thank you, Sandra.
So I'm so glad you all are here. This is a wonderful way to throw myself a party. But let's get the party started. Let's welcome, we've got Bryan Lubeck. Bryan has just released Midnight Sun, number one Billboard chart and top-selling Amazon seller. So you guys are in for a treat. Let's give a warm welcome to Bryan Lubeck. Thank you.
John Erickson. Tim King. Thank you. Again, Tim King on the sax, John Erickson playing that thingy. I don't know what it's called to this day, John. The horn thingy. Yeah, that's good. And Nate Lackney on the drums back there. You know, it is such a thrill to be opening for such great acts. I love this, you know. Hopefully I'm setting the stage well because you've got some awesome talent that you're gonna see coming up. I was just blown away during the rehearsals. So sit tight. I will try not to mess that up before we get there. But as Sandra said, we just came out with a new album. Very lucky, lots of radio play. If you listen to Sirius XM Watercolors, you will see us pop up a few times a day. It's a blessing in these times, as you can imagine, when the pandemic hit, all of the musicians that were out touring stayed home, and what did they do? They wrote music, right? And so, you know, I had already written the album, but we were still in production, and you've got to do, you know, videos, and you've got to, you know, deal with distributors and all that stuff. So it took a while. We finally released it in August, and our radio promoter was like, I just don't, he's like, there is so much great music out there, and it's all of the people that I look up to were also coming out with music all at the same time. And the fact that the album, especially the song Invincible, hit the radio waves and got so much play. I think we were in the top 20 for quite a while, and like I said, reached bestseller on Amazon. It's just a blessing. So, and a lot of that was we kept busy, and we played a few shows here, a couple that were remote, you know. If you tuned in for those, we did a Christmas one as well, and so it's awesome to be back here on the stage. I would love to play you the title track off of Midnight Sun for you, if that's okay. You ready to hear some new music? All right. And we also brought a few, we got a few albums back from the distributor. We've just been selling quite a bit, so that's awesome. We've got 30 albums out there. They're $10 a piece, and all the proceeds will go back to the Acorn. We're going to just make that happen. So take us home with you. All right, here we go. Midnight Sun. ¶¶ much. Thanks. We've got one more for you, but before we start the show, that's really how I look at it. Like I said, you are in for a treat. This next song is, as you can tell, I've got kind of this weird mix of, I don't know, Spanish guitar, pop, a little bit of jazz. You might hear a little bit of my early days touring as a 13-year-old in a bluegrass and country band kind of come out every once in a while. Might come out at our jam song a little bit there, too. But this one is back to kind of my flamenco roots, which is weird for me to say. I grew up in Goshen, Indiana. You know, the heartland of flamenco guitar music. I had a teacher in Millersburg, which was even tinier than Goshen, Indiana, and she taught piano, bass, guitar, and drums, and mandolin. And so that's why we had enough of those instruments to tour for 2 or 3 years in our early teens, which was such a blessing. And I remember showing up to her one time, and since we've got so many guitarists in the audience, I'll tell this little extra part of the story. So, you know, I was, you know, you're taught to do individual notes, you know, right? Okay, I got that, yep, with a pick, by the way. And, you know, she also taught me how to strum, and I was like, that's awesome, but it's boring, because I want, like, everything to happen all at once. So I was like, oh, can I make this work? And this is the song that I came up with. I remember I showed up, probably 14 or something, I showed up to her. Does anybody know what that is? Could you tell? Yeah, a little bit of Cats. And she immediately was like, okay, we're going to go a different direction, grabbed a Segovia classical book. Again, we're in Millersburg, Indiana, and there's a Segovia classical guitar teaching book. And from then on, I kind of got the bug for Latin music. This next tune is a tune called Mano Caliente. How many of you know what that means? Hot hands, there we go. It's usually a contest between Nate and I to see where this ends up going. Sometimes we don't know. We'll let you be the judge who gets the Hot Hands award at the end of this tune. Come on up, Sandra. We are ready to hear the next folks in line. I'm excited. All right. Thank you so much for having us. I so appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks, Bryan. I just want to walk down the beach by my house and have Bryan and these guys play the soundtrack to my life, you know?
And the wind blowing through your hair.
And we could wear capes and stuff and just... Thanks, guys.
So many of you already know this very handsome, very talented gentleman to my right. It's Peter Carey, and he surprised me tonight because often he has co-emceed with me for our open mics, and it's such a pleasure. He's here tonight, so go ahead, introduce our... Yeah.
I wouldn't miss this for the world. It's been a pleasure. I know there's been a lot of gushing, but thank you. You've welcomed me into this place. You've opened the doors, and you've given me wonderful times under the stars, and thanks.
Thank you, Peter. Who's coming up next?
Who's coming up next? Another friend of the Acorn. Please welcome Patti Shattner.
So glad to be here tonight. I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Sandra. And I mean that seriously. I did my first singer-songwriter contest back in 2014, and she's done nothing but encourage me and other local talents. And that's one of the things that really, really makes the Acorn special, don't you think? And I see we have future singers. So I can keep things moving along. This is a song of mine. It's on my album, which also happens to be out there. It's called Balancing Act, but it's about we need someone beside us to help us kind of figure out what's going on in this world. So this is Balancing Act. It's a crazy world, gonna have to get away from it all. It's such a crazy world, you know there ain't no safe place to fall. And moment to moment it's a balancing act, you gotta stay light on your feet and ready to move if the blow comes your way, or lean into something sweet in a crazy world. Yeah, it's a crazy world, you know you need someone on your side to help you steer the boat, stay afloat, find the breeze, help you turn the tide. Moment to moment, it's a gambler's game, hoping to beat all the odds and saying a prayer as the wheel starts to spin to the fates or the unseen gods. In a crazy world, yeah, you know, a crazy world. And it's easy to see why it all falls apart, 'cause we try to hang on to the prize. But I hope that you'll come and dance, take a chance, and look this fool in the eyes. Yeah, it's a crazy world, here we are on the edge, looking over the side. It's such a crazy world, who'd have thought together we'd take this ride. And moment to moment, it's a balancing act. Love is for fools, they say. But we're heading off on a wing and a prayer to the light of a brand new day in a crazy world. A crazy world. Sweet Sabbath day, apart, cause we try to hang on to the prize. But I hope that you'll come and dance, take a chance, look this fool in the eyes. Yeah, it's a crazy world, here we are on the edge, looking over the side. It's such a crazy world, who'd have thought together we'd take this ride. Moment to moment, it's a balancing act. Yes, love is for fools, so they say. But we're heading off on a wing and a prayer to the promise of a brand new day in a crazy world. Yeah, you know, a crazy world. Such a crazy, crazy world. So, you know, as a songwriter, people always are asking, how do you write songs? And the best songs that I've ever written are ones that come like a lightning flash. And this song is something that I really believe my husband gave to me. My husband passed away a couple years ago. And I believe that he sent this to me because I was walking from my front door to my kitchen, and the entire first verse and the entire melody came to me in a flash. And within 24 hours, I had a song. So this is, I Will Be Here Still. Hang a wooden harp from a branch in a willow tree. Let it weather there. Plant a seed. sweet. There let it rest and through the winter keep, as spring does come and the seed will grow. When you see that green, you will surely know that I'm loving you. Thank you. Thanks to Bryan for all that lovely music, too. And again, thanks to Sandra and to the Acorn. This is an amazing place, and keep supporting it, please.
Thank you, Patti. Rodney Mills is coming up to the stage. This is Rodney's first time here on the Acorn stage. As he's coming up, there's a couple great things coming up at the Acorn, and one of them, first before I tell it to you guys, tomato, tomato, how many tomatoes out there? Say it, tomato, how many tomatoes? Tomatoes, okay, so more tomatoes and tomatoes. All right, I'm gonna spell this one. I wanted you guys to speak out loud, ready? A-B-B-A. I hear ABBA and ABBA, and I can't, I keep going back and forth. Dancing Queen is coming Wednesday before Thanksgiving. They've been here before. They are one amazing tribute band to ABBA, ABBA. So I can consider consider coming. All right, you guys, please warm welcome to Rodney Mills.
I'm going to do a few original songs here. And to say I wasn't nervous would be an understatement here. First time here. Help me find I have stood in the shoes of a giant. I have laid where kings have reigned. But I've never been loved by a woman like the way that you love me. You can't tell me it's all been in vain, all the world suffering and all the pain. And you can't tell me we'll die alone, 'cause I have faith, Lord, that we'll meet in the end. So won't you take me to the river? Won't you take me to the sea? Help me stand on, stand and deliver. Help me find the light I see. That's the cut down version. Thank you. Sitting here waiting on the sun, watching the wind blow all those leaves away, waiting on a miracle, holding on to faith. Staring out the window for my love to come. Then you're around the corner, I see your smiling face. Oh Lord, it looks like happy days. I said, oh time.
Thank you, Rodney. Do us a favor. Come back again, okay? Really nice. You know, when Tom was talking about Sandra up here and about the Acorn, he hit right on that nugget of truth that this place is special. It's so welcoming. It has a magic all its own, and that's why they say the one and only Acorn. And this night is so special. What great music. Bryan Lubeck said it. What a great, great show. And please welcome one of my favorite musical storytellers, Mr. Bryan Kanyer, to the stage.
I just want to say thanks for allowing me to play here over the years. I mean, you just listen to this wonderful talent, and she still lets me play, so that's all nice. Everybody's done all these wonderful original songs, and I will not. So mine are a couple covers. Hopefully you haven't heard them. The first one is a song about human anatomy, curiosity, interesting rapping, and excessive alcohol consumption. It's written by Brian Bowers. It's called The Scotsman. Well, a Scotsman clad in kilt left the bar one evening fair. One could tell by how he walked that he'd drunk more than his share. Fumbled round until he could no longer keep his feet. Then he stumbled off into the grass to sleep beside the street. Hum-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di-di- Well, about that time, two young and lovely girls just happened by. And one says to the other with a twinkle in her eye, "See yon sleeping Scotsman, so strong and handsome built. I wonder if it's true what they don't wear beneath the kilt. Hum dum diddle little lighty eye, hum di did the I-O. I wonder if it's true what they don't wear beneath the kilt." Well, they crept up on that sleeping Scotsman, quiet as could be. Lifted up his kilt about an inch so they could see. And there before their eyes to view, beneath his Scottish skirt, was nothing more that God had graced him with upon his birth. Hum di did a little lighty I, hum di did the I O, was nothing more than God had graced him with upon his birth. Well, they marveled for a moment, then one said, "We must be gone. Let's leave a present for our friend before we move along." As a gift, they left a blue silk ribbon tied into a bow. Around the bonnie star, the Scots' kilt did lift and show. Hum di did a little lighty hi, hum di did the I-O. Around the bonnie star, the Scots' kilt did lift and show. Well, the Scotsman woke to nature's call and stumbled towards a tree. Behind the bush he lifts his kilt and gawks at what he sees. And in a startled voice he says to what's before his eyes,
Hi, lad, I don't know where you've been, but I see you won first prize. Hyundai did a little lady, I Hyundai did the I.O. Lad, I don't know where you've been, but I see you won first prize. So much for the serious tone of tonight's show. This one's a little bit different. This is Veterans Day, and my dad was a veteran of World War II and Korea both, so that's an important day for me. So, yeah, thank you. Thank you to all the veterans out there for all the service and everything you've done for us. It's incredible. This is a song by Eric Bogle, who is he's in Scotland now, but he was born, actually he was born in Scotland, he's in Australia now. And he wrote this song in 1971. And it's about a battle in World War I in Gallipoli, Turkey. Some of you may know about that. The group, kind of the Axis powers, Germany, but really in this area, it was the Turks, the Ottoman Empire were there. And the Allied forces, which were the United Kingdom or England at that time, France, wanted to bust through to get into Constantinople or Istanbul. And they even brought up some troops from Australia and New Zealand called the ANZACs, Australian New Zealand Army Corps. And so these people came up there, this is in 1915, the guys came up and they got killed, they got wiped out. And Bryan wrote a song about a survivor of that battle. And the song is in the band, played Waltzing Matilda. If you know Waltzing Matilda, that's sort of the unofficial national anthem of Australia and New Zealand. You'll hear it at some political events, sporting events, things like that. Kind of like our Yankee Doodle Dandy or God Bless America. But a Matilda is actually a bedroll that you take with you when you're out waltzing or hiking. So if you're waltzing your Matilda, you're hiking. And you'll also hear the word billabong, and that's an oxbow lake. So still to this day, on April 25th, they celebrate Anzac Day in Australia and New Zealand. So this is, and the band played Waltzing Matilda. Now when I was a young man, I carried me pack, and I lived the free life of a rover. From the Murray's Green Basin to the dusty outback, well, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time to quit rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat, they gave me a gun, and they marched me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as the ship pulled away from the quay. Amidst all the cheers, the flag waving and tears, we sailed up for Gallipoli. And how well I remember that terrible day, blood stained the sand and the water, and of how in that hell that they called Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter. Johnny Turkey, who was waiting, he primed himself well. He rained us with bullets and he showered us with shells. And in 5 minutes flat, he'd blown us straight to hell. Here he blew us right back to Australia. But the band played Waltzing Matilda as we paused to bury our slain. We buried ours, the Turks buried theirs, then we started it all over again. And
those that were left, well, we tried to survive in that mad world of blood, death, and fire. And for nearly 10 weeks, I kept myself alive, while around me the corpses piled higher. When a big turkey shell knocked me ass overhead, and when I woke up in me hospital bed and saw what it had done, well, I'd wished I was dead. Never knew there was worse things than dying, for there'll be no more waltzing Matilda out through the green bush far and free, to hump tens and pegs a man needs both legs. No more waltzing Matilda for me. So they gathered the crippled, the wounded, the maimed, and they shipped us back home to Australia. The legless, the armless, the blind, the insane, those proud wounded heroes of Suvla. And when our ship pulled into Circular Cay, and I looked at the place where me legs used to be, and thank God there was nobody waiting for me to grieve, to mourn, to pity. But the band played Waltzing Matilda as they carried us down the gangway. But nobody cheered, they just stood and stared. Then they turned all their faces away. And now, every April, I sit on my porch and I watch the parade pass before me. And I see me old comrades, how proudly they march, reviving old dreams of past glory. And the old men march slowly, a bold defense over their tired old heroes from a forgotten war. And the young people ask, what are they marching for? And I ask myself the same question. But the band plays Waltzing Matilda, and the old men still answer the call. But as year follows year, more old men disappear. Someday no one will march there at all. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, who'll come a waltzing Matilda with me? And their ghosts may be heard as they march by that billabong. Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Thanks, Bryan. Always love listening to you and the stories that you tell so beautifully. Okay, we got to bring up my trio. I'm introducing my own trio tonight, Michelle Rumsa and Bryan Lubeck. Come on up, you guys. Oh, there's Bryan. So while they're getting set up, we've got a great weekend coming up, the first weekend in December. On the 3rd of December, we have the Nielsen Trust, as in Cheap Trick Rick Nielsen and two of his sons, and Miles Nielsen's wife. Miles has been here with his band several times, and we got a big following for Miles. This time, though, he's coming with his dad. He's going to be on our stage. So that's going to be a lot of fun. And then on the 4th of December, we've got We Banjo 3. And many of you are not going, oh, We Banjo 3, who are they? But all I have to say is, do you know Mumford and Sons, right? The music of Mumford and Sons. We Banjo 3, that's the what you're going to hear with We Banjo 3. Their style, they're from Ireland, they're adorable, and they're really talented. They sing great harmony and play banjos. All right, oh my gosh, you guys are ready. Well, so Bryan, we've had an issue with our, we don't have a name.
And you know, you're right. So, you know, there's been a lot of silver linings through the pandemic. And one of my silver linings is, you know, when you're touring and you're got a seven-piece band and all that stuff, you're just kind of going from one thing to the other. You're just preparing for a show. And sometimes you don't really get a chance to just play music for fun. And the best part about music for fun for me is I have been, you know, about once a week, we all get together and we just open up a book and we start playing music. And sometimes it sucks, and sometimes you're like, wow, this is great. And that's, to me, when music is really music, right? It's not just, it's you don't care what else is happening around you. It's just fun to be together and play. So that's been my silver lining, is to play with these two. And we're going to play just a couple of songs as if you're in the living room with us. So just don't put your feet on the furniture. Other than that, we're just going to play. You need to do a little tuning, right? All right. Shell's going to do tuning. Cellos are fussy, but not cello players. All right. Okay. Is that on? Can you hear it?
Make sure the volume's up on that.
By the way, this is a moment where we have to really appreciate our tech, Jamie Wagner. Everybody, a round of applause for Jamie. This is not easy. Doing an open mic. Jamie, thank you.
All right, so this first song we're gonna do is just one that we literally opened a book on and just went, wow, we really like this. It's a gospel tune. It's from before the Civil War, sometime in the early 1800s. I did research this. And it's called Wayfaring Stranger. It's an old folk tune. And here we go. Going there to meet my Savior. I'm going there to meet my Lord. I'm only going over Jordan. I'm only going over.
just a poor wayfaring stranger, traveling through this world of woe. And there's no sickness, toil, no danger in this bright world to which I go.
I'm going. Are you getting a good signal out there? Seems to be going in and out up here. Can we get just a little bit more of the guitar and the monitor? Be great. All right, we're going to do one more for you. You ready for this?
I'm so ready.
We've been practicing. All right, here we go.
See if we can get the words right.
Talk right now.
Stop.
I need a little space. Ooh, ooh. Wait. Didn't mean to say it like that. Losing my mind again.
Go slow.
touch me like you do. Don't you know you're the fire in my bones? You're my heart and my home. Oh. And I know I don't say enough. I've been down on my love.
Sandra,
Bryan Michelle Rumza. Michelle's debut on the cello ever in front of people.
I think it's the starting of a new group. Lubeck, Thompson, Rumza, here it is, live on stage.
We need a name. We
LRT.
A name. I like that.
Well, you know, Lubeck,
like just one
Thompson,
word, like
Rumza.
Sting.
Well, maybe, maybe if somebody gives us a great name, they can get a CD. One of your CDs.
I love that. I love that. Yeah, let us know your name if you think about it. All right, thanks again. Who we got up next? I got to tell you, this has been amazing.
So, Bryan, will you stay up here and just sort of play background music? This is a very important part of the Acorn Open Mics.
This is the only artist that shows up at every single open mic night.
Jamie, can you pull the house lights up?
Pass the basket.
It's on the program.
As you know, it's free to come here tonight, and the emotion and the love and the joy and the music is absolutely fabulous. It's free, and we ask that you dig into your pockets and help maintain our nonprofit status and keep the doors open and the lights on here at the Acorn. So, one of the things that I've always noticed is even the artists that come here to play dig into their pockets, and it's a good feeling. So thank you, everybody.
As I think all of you, it goes without saying, but I'll say it anyway, this place, this venue, this space, there's nothing like it. You can go all over the country, and there just isn't anything like this place.
It is the one
and
only.
Debra, you should be coming up here to get ready. Debra plays harp. Oh. Right.
Way to go, Jane.
Earlier tonight, I saw somebody over at the bar say this is their first time at the Acorn. Any other first-timers here tonight? Welcome aboard. Thank you. Thanks, guys. Careful. You get the Acorn buzz here, and you want to come back again and again. Thank you.
Well, on behalf of the Acorn, thanks for being so generous as we pass the basket. Time to get things going once again. Please welcome to the Acorn stage, for the first time, Angry Napkins.
Softly in this world. Thank you very much. Before I go on, I have to introduce the rest of the members here. First of all, we have on percussion Freddy, the Latin love god, Cruz. We have the lovely and gracious Ann Cruz on keys and vocals. And I am John. That is a household name. You should remember it.
Inimitable John Schneider.
We have another one for you featuring Ann, so we're going to get going here.
I hear the ticking of the clock. I'm lying here, the room's pitch dark. And the night goes by so very slow. Oh, I hope that it won't end, though. The secret is still my own, and my love for you is still unknown, alone.
Thank you very much.
Angry napkins. If you want to know why their name is Angry Napkins, you can ask them after the show. Debra plays harp. Come on up, Miss Debra. gosh, look at this. Whoa. I know, it's pretty awesome. This is the Acorn Open Mic. And this is Debra Plays Harp. My God. Debra has been here before, but this is the debut of your gorgeous harp here on the Acorn stage. I can't wait to hear it.
That was invented by my mentor, Debra Henson Conant, and she developed this harp to be able to wear on her body. So it's 11 pounds. I'm not ready to wear it on my body yet. Watching the Tour de France, that bicycles are light. So this is kind of based on a bicycle. Okay. This doesn't work, does it? Not that I need this right away, but so this is a song by Jerry Lieber and Phil Spector. Little less bass. Thank you. This thing is very bassy. A little more than that. Spanish Harlem, a red rose up in Spanish Harlem, with eyes as black as coal that look down in your soul and light a fire there, and then you lose control, you have to beg your pardon. Him as he grows. In my garden. La 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 la.
Thank you. Thank you. This next song I'm going to do was written in 1926, and nobody ever does the verse to this song. Everyone knows the chorus, so I'm going to do the verse because it gives the song meaning, meaning. So, see, I can't see a thing up here. It's just blinding. But there we go. There we go. No, it's not that either. So, you forget that there's levers on this harp. There we go. So I can't see anything. There we go. Blackbird. Blackbird, singing the blues all day. Right outside my door. Blackbird, blackbird, why do you sit and say, there's no sunshine in store. All through the winter, you hung around. Now I begin to feel homeward bound. Blackbird, blackbird, gotta be on my way. Where the sun shines galore. Pack up all my cares and woe, here I go, singing low. Bye, bye, blackbird. Where somebody waits for me, sugar's sweet, so is he. Bye, bye, blackbird. No one here can wait or understand me. Oh, what hard luck stories they all hand me. So make my bed and light the light. I'll arrive late tonight, blackbird. No one here can love or understand me. Oh, what hard luck stories they all hand me. So make my bed and light the light. I'll arrive late tonight, blackbird. Blackbird. bye, bye.
Debra more than plays harp. I loved it. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow. Fascinating. Thanks, Debra.
You're welcome.
You ready, Kylie? All right, let's do the handoff here.
Woo!
Yeah. Please welcome Kyla Webb.
Yay. Hi, everybody. Thanks for having me. This is my first time at the open mic at Acorn Theater. Woo woo. I've actually spent the night here, though. I've slept here about like 16 years ago. I spent a weekend here with a bunch of black and white clowns that did a show here for a long time. So I was only 3 years old at the time. A joke, but thank you. I'll take it as a compliment. The lack of laughs, I'll take that as a compliment. I'm gonna do some songs that I wrote. How about that? Here we go.
Blood is thicker than water, as long as you monitor the tap. I am the son of your father. You owe me more respect than that. Hey, feel me, listen and obey, 'cause mine is the only way. Sin. I was born better, I win. I make the righteous choice. Arrogant misery in my voice. Love is given on my terms. It's not unconditional, it must be earned. I am the one that you rely on. All decisions must be cleared by me. Your life is purely what I make it. I am the father, so I take it. Anything I choose not to believe, no. Never wanna know, never wanna see. Anything I choose not to believe. I feel the things I don't understand. My hate makes me the bigger man. I'm the big man. Privilege rules my village, so thank me now for all that I have done. Step out of line and I will scold you, set an example for my oldest son. Even when I die all alone, and I can go knowing I was never wrong.
God, 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 come.
'cause I got a God complex.
I wrote that about bigots. All right, this is another song I wrote. I feel like it's pretty self-explanatory, too. Also, okay.
If a story needs a villain, then you already cast me in the part. So tell us one again about how she destroyed your fragile heart. Ego's just a notion, so let the truth be spoken. You let her keep you broken as you struggle not to drown. But you made this bed, and I think it's time you lay down. But don't come to me for any more of my sympathy. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You cry and complain, and you never make a change. Oh, you cry. Take more than you were, and you refuse to learn. You cry and complain, and you never make a change. Oh, you cry and complain, and do more of the same. It's a waste of my time. Listen to what's on your mind. These four walls of cage you built with your own two hands. Got carried away and let someone else make your plans. Take a look through your tears, straight into the mirror. You keep on choosing fear and calling back for more. We've heard it a million times, your sob story, it's a bore. But don't come to me for any more of my sympathy. Yeah. You cry and complain, and you never make a change. Oh, you cry and complain, and do more of the same. Take more than you earn, and you refuse to learn. Hey. You cry and complain, and you never make a change. Oh, you cry and complain, and do more of the same. It's a waste of my time. Listen to what's on your mind. You only talk about yourself. Do you hear yourself? You only talk about yourself. It's getting bad for my health, sitting around listening you talk about yourself. Everyone has one. We all have at least one. Is that true? Okay, right. It's like, come on, get your life together. Anyway, every story needs a winner, and I have chosen to be them. Think I'll be okay if I never have to see you again. Let's face up to the facts, see where we're at. You're holding everyone back by not moving on. I'll do us all the favor, pack my shit and get gone. I'm serious. For any more of my sympathy. Yeah, hey. You cry and complain, and you never make a change. Oh, you cry and complain, and do more of the same. Take more than you earn, and you refuse to learn. You cry and complain, and you never make a change. Oh, you cry and complain, and do more of the same. Waste of my time. It's a waste of my time. Listen to what's on your mind. It's a waste of my time.
Woo! Yeah! Give it up for all the performers and the organizer. Thank you, guys. Hopefully, I'll see you again soon. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Well. Kyla Webb. And you saw her first here at the Acorn, right? Thanks for bringing it. Hey, turn around, show them the hat. Truth, baby. See what I mean? Fun. Good stuff here. Chris Reagan, you ready? The Sandra Thompson Farewell Tour continues. Please welcome Chris Reagan to the stage.
Just a small fry, they're too gun shy to have his heart touch without a glove. If love knew him, he would walk up to him and introduce him to his love. Love has no mind, it can't spell unkind. It's never seen a heart shaped like a valentine. If love knew him, he would walk up to him and introduce him to nameless love. I've been out walking, kind of pillow talking to anyone who has time for me. I know some. They think that love chokes, that only keeps them from being free. Love has no mind, it can't spell unkind. It's never seen a heart shaped like a valentine. If love knew him, he would walk up to him and introduce him to a nameless love. He would introduce him to a nameless thing.
Thank you. This next song is a song I wrote for my daughter. She had raised in the Midwest and working in Chicago and decided she wanted to live somewhere else in the country, took a job in Seattle. And at first it was, exciting and a lot of anticipation, and that kind of morphed into a little bit of dread and second guessing and doubt, and that was just me. But so I wrote this song, kind of part advice, part reassurance.
The road is long, it twists and turns. Journey on, for all you yearn. No one can say which way to go. It's up to you, you will know. There comes a point, the path divides. You can play it safe or take a ride. There may be fear, anxiety, but facing it can set you free. No time or space can separate the ones you love that fascinate. Matters not what sky you view, always know we'll be there for you. The universe throws a gauntlet down, you can take it up or step around. No guarantee of a second chance. When the music starts, better join the dance. No time or space can separate the ones you love that captivate. It matters not what sky you view. Always know we'll be there for you. So journey down that hero's road. There'll be battles lost, victories bestowed. Times may get rough, not quite ideal. Keep searching for what's true and real. No time or space can separate the ones you love and celebrate. It matters not what sky you view. Always know we'll be there for you. Always know we'll be there for you. Remember this, we'll always be with you.
Thank you, Chris. All right, we'd like to welcome Bubba and Dawn Rogers up on the stage. This is their first time, their debut on the Acorn stage. We want to say a special thank you to you guys. I know it's been a longer open mic night than we're used to, but stick around. After Bubba and Dawn, we've got Richard, and then we've got our favorite jam, and tonight is Brown Eyed Girl. We want all you guys to sing with us. They hadn't taken so long on that dedication thing. Oh my God. Yeah. I'm like, no, this doesn't fit in the program. No. Come on, chop, chop.
Good evening. I'm Dawn and this is Bubba.
Wait a second.
If you have any requests, please keep them to yourself. We barely know the songs we're gonna do for you tonight. That's a little bit bright. We're going to do a little bit of Johnny Cash and June Carter. This is an original, but we didn't write it. Somebody else originally wrote this.
It's a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring.
Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire.
I fell into a burning ring of fire.
I went down, down, down,
and the flames went higher. Of love is sweet when hearts like ours meet.
I felt you like a child. Oh, but the fire went wild.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. Went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire, went down.
We sure thank you.
Thank you.
I would like to tip my hat to all the veterans and all the military on this Veterans Day. Thank you very much for your service and fighting for my freedom. I sure appreciate it. We've got another little number here worked up. We've been practicing back over at the house. I'm going to use my capo on this one here. And I'll be in the C chord in case anybody was wondering what chord I was in here.
Ever since that fire went out, I'm going to Jackson. Gonna mess around. I'm going to Jackson. Look out, Jackson Town. I'm gonna snowball Jackson.
See if I care.
When I breeze into that city, people gonna stoop and bow.
Ha!
All them women trying to make me teach them what they don't know how. And I'm gonna Jackson. Turn loose of my coat. I'm gone to Jackson.
Goodbye, that's all she wrote. But they'll laugh at you in Jackson. And I'll be dancing on a pony keg. They'll lead you around town like a scalded hound with your tail tucked between your legs. Yeah, go to Jackson. You big talking man. That fire went out. I'm going to Jackson. And that's a fact. We're going to Jackson. Ain't never coming back.
We got married in a fever. Hotter than a pepper. Thank you.
Thank you.
Dawn and Bubba, thank you. And thanks for the Johnny Cash, too. That was fun.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Let's keep rolling. Please welcome to the Acorn stage, Richard Cameron.
Thank you.
I'm going to give you a little bit of harmonica music. First song is going to be a blues song called IOU Blues, written by a great harmonica player by the name of Joe Felisco. Thank you. Well, this next song is an Irish song. It's a traditional Irish song called The Morning Star.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Richard Cameron, thank you, sir. That was fabulous.
Thank you, Richard. And we now get to call all of our fabulous open mic performers back up to the stage for Brown Eyed Girl. It's going to take a couple minutes.
Yeah, it'll take a couple secs to get everybody back here. Bryan, you're the choir director, man. You set it up. And as we're getting everybody back up here, thanks for staying up a little extra with us, staying out a little later than normal. If your parents are mad at us, give us a call and Sandra will explain everything, okay?
All right, let's hear it for these performers. It's not often that I get to open for, I think it's 14 of you or something, awesome performers. And I love, too, that we get a chance to hear all different kinds of styles and inspirations and covers and originals and all of that stuff. But we wanted to get ourselves together here. It's a great tradition at the Acorn where we're going to play something all together. We're going to take some turns, singing, playing. There might be twists and turns as well, but I want you all to start kind of warming up too, because we might turn it over to you at any moment. So when I point, that means it's time. All right.
I don't know if you all knew this, but Jamie Wagner is not only a great sound tech, he's also an incredible piano player. So he's going to be joining us on this one. It's amazing.
Okay, I think I remember our plan. Are we close? Okay. Wow, this is awesome. We get a harp up here and guitars and...
Jamie, you call this a hootenanny, don't you? Hootenanny.
All right, we're going to try to make this our own, and by our, I mean all of you as well. Here we go. Now, hey, where do we go? Days when the rains came down in the hollow, playing a new game, laughing and running, hey, sipping and siding all along the waterfall with our hearts thumping and you, my brown eyed girl. Brown eyed girl. Here we go with the second verse.
What happened? Tuesday is so slow.
All right, take it.
Coming down the old man with a transistor radio.
Stadium with you, brown-eyed girl. sing. Sha la 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 da. Sha la 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 da.
Sing again.
Sha la 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 da.
We're gonna hear from a couple of instrumentalists. Here we go. Let's go with the harp. For the piano, here we go. Sing sha la 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 di da. Oh yeah.
Sha la 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 di da.
Oh, sha la di da.
Sha la 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 di da.
Sha
la 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 di da.
La di da. I think we need a little bit of flat picking. Are you ready for this? Here we go. One, two, one, two. Oh, three. On the piano, make a little wave for him. One, two, ready. Yeah. la-di-da. I love it when you don't plan an ending, but it ends perfectly. Thank you all for joining us tonight and being a part of the music. And Sandra, it's going to be hard not seeing you up here.
December 2nd, next open mic. Be there, be square.
Be there, be square. All right. We'll see you again sometime down the road. Again, please keep the Acorn going for us. They need you. Show up at shows. Do what you can. Support the music. And we'll see you back here again soon. Bye-bye.